It's inevitable that while working with a mechanical ventilator, you will eventually experience a problem. This is when ventilator troubleshooting comes in handy. By knowing the most common problems that can occur and how to troubleshoot them, you can ensure that your patient is receiving the ventilatory support that they need. In this video, we will discuss some of the most common problems that occur during mechanical ventilation and how to promptly solve them. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, ventilator troubleshooting is the process of identifying and solving a problem that occurs in the patient-ventilator connection. This is important because when a problem occurs, it can cause the patient to experience discomfort or even put their life at risk. The goal of ventilator troubleshooting is to quickly identify the problem and then take the necessary steps to solve it. This process requires extensive knowledge and understanding of the principles of mechanical ventilation. In a perfect world, the delivery of mechanical ventilatory support would be flawless and we would never experience any problems. However, of course, this is not the case. There are various problems that can occur during mechanical ventilation, including the following. The first that I should mention is respiratory distress. When a patient on the ventilator experiences a problem, one of the first signs you'll see is respiratory distress. This includes signs and symptoms such as tachypnea, tachycardia, nasal flaring, diaphoresis, paradoxical thoracic movement, arrhythmias, dyspnea on exertion, accessory muscle usage, and pursed lip breathing. When you notice one or more of these symptoms, especially when accompanied by the sounding of a ventilator alarm, it's a sure sign that something is wrong and you need to take action. And that leads perfectly to the next problem, which is ventilator alarms. Ventilator alarms serve as a safety mechanism and use a set of parameters to provide alerts whenever a problem arises in the patient-ventilator interaction. The alarms may be audible, visual, or both, depending on the ventilator mode and settings. There are several different types of alarms that may sound whenever a problem arises, including high pressure, low volume, high frequency, apnea, high PEEP, and low PEEP. We have a separate video that covers all of the alarms in detail, so definitely check that out if you want to learn more. But another common problem during mechanical ventilation is system leaks. A system leak occurs when there is a disconnection, a problem with the circuit, or a problem with the artificial airway. Some signs of a leak during mechanical ventilation include the sounding of the low pressure alarm, low volume alarm, the low minute ventilation alarm, or if you see abnormal ventilator graphics. If the leak is due to a disconnection, you'll simply need to reconnect the circuit. If the problem is with the artificial airway, you may need to check the cuff pressure and add more air to the cuff. Otherwise, you'll need to replace the artificial airway. The next problem that may occur is inadequate oxygenation. If the patient is not receiving enough oxygen, the low SpO2 alarm will sound. In this case, an arterial blood gas should be analyzed to confirm that hypoxemia is present. Then you can adjust the FiO2 or PEEP settings accordingly, depending on the patient's needs. Refractory hypoxemia is another oxygenation problem that can occur during mechanical ventilation in severe cases. This is when the patient's SpO2 does not increase despite a high FiO2 setting. This is often a sign of acute respiratory distress syndrome and requires treatment with high levels of PEEP. The next problem that I want to mention is patient-ventilator asynchrony, or disynchrony, whichever one you prefer. Ventilator disynchrony is characterized by inappropriate timing of a delivered breath between a patient and the mechanical ventilator. This increases the work of breathing and makes it more difficult for the patient to breathe comfortably while on the machine. Correcting ventilator disynchrony depends on the specific cause of the problem. It usually involves inappropriate ventilator settings. Therefore, making proper adjustments is the best treatment method. For example, you may need to adjust the flow, sensitivity, or inspiratory time. or you may consider using a different ventilator mode. In general, the less control the ventilator has on the patient's respiratory pattern, the less likely they will experience ventilator asynchrony. Moving right along, next up on the list is artificial airway problems. Several problems can occur during mechanical ventilation when using an artificial airway. Some examples include disconnection, cuff leak, obstruction, incorrect placement, a malfunctioning valve, tube kinking, and tube biting by the patient. If a severe problem arises with an artificial airway, the patient should be disconnected and manually ventilated with a bag valve mask. However, if the tube is fully obstructed, it must be removed to deliver manual breaths. This requires re-intubation with a new endotracheal tube. Next up on this list is secretion buildup. Airway suctioning is required during mechanical ventilation to avoid the accumulation of excess mucus and secretions. This typically involves the use of an inline suction catheter that is connected directly to the endotracheal tube. Copious secretions may occur in conditions such as pulmonary edema, cystic fibrosis, bronchiectasis, and respiratory infections. Suctioning should only be performed when indicated, and the patient may also benefit from receiving warm, humidified air. Other types of airway clearance therapy, such as chest physiotherapy, may also be used to help clear secretions. Another common problem to be aware of is Auto-PEEP. Auto-PEEP is a complication of mechanical ventilation that occurs when a positive pressure remains in the alveoli at the end exhalation phase of the breathing cycle. This can result in patient-ventilator asynchrony, making it uncomfortable for them to breathe while on the machine. A high PEEP alarm may sound whenever Auto-PEEP or air trapping is present. In general, this can be corrected by prolonging the patient's expiratory time. And another major problem that can occur during mechanical ventilation is an accidental extubation. This occurs when the endotracheal tube is inadvertently removed from the patient's trachea. This also includes self-extubation, which is the deliberate removal of the tube by the patient. An unplanned extubation is a severe complication in patients who are reliant on high levels of ventilatory support. However, this can be prevented by properly securing the artificial airway in place with tape or a tube holder. The patient should also be monitored closely for any signs of agitation or distress. So just to give a quick recap, some of the most common problems that can occur when a patient is on the ventilator include respiratory distress, ventilator alarms, system leaks, circuit disconnection, inadequate oxygenation, patient ventilator asynchrony, artificial airway problems, secretion buildup, Auto-PEEP, and an accidental extubation, just to name a few. But of course, there are many other problems that can arise depending on the type of ventilator, mode, settings, artificial airway, or the patient's condition. These are just some of the most common problems that respiratory therapists and students must be aware of. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.